Welcome to Painting Equipment Focus for Oils. This is a rich and exciting medium, and not to fully exploit its potential would be to miss a fulfilling experience. Showing you how to use your painting equipment, how to exploit its characteristics, how to maximize its usage, is key to my method of tutoring, for I firmly believe that working effectively with a core painting kit is far more fulfilling than possessing vast quantities of brushes, paints and so on, which is why my oil painting tutorials are based on a core kit of materials which forms the basis of my own. 6 oil paints plus 2 whites, the 6 colour nucleus of the colour circle, from which you can mix nearly all of the colours ever need, plus 2 whites that are essential for working successfully in oils. My kit comprises one medium-sized round bristle brush and one large plus a medium-sized soft hairbrush. In this video, I not only introduce you to these brushes, but also go through a number of different types available to the oil painter. In oil painting, particularly using traditional techniques, it's important to understand the fundamental attributes of the various mediums and thinners and their roles. For without this knowledge, you will not achieve those rich, luscious qualities that are inherent in oil painting, which would be a shame. Although you can use any non-absorbent surface as a palette, in this video I show you the traditional wooden kidney-shaped palette, plus a rectangular one, and how to exploit its shape to maximise your colour mixing experience. In the accompanying video, I go on to show how to exploit the palette to ensure you get the maximum usage out of your paint mixes. By understanding how to mix colour on the palette, you will learn how to control your colour mixes so that you can effectively achieve the correct hues, values and tones in your painting, which are the building blocks needed to achieve volume, depth and light in any composition. Varnishing oil paintings. This seemingly simple subject can confuse, which is why it has been distilled down to the two principal varnishes that I use. What could be so difficult about applying a finishing varnish? You may well ask. Surprisingly, much can go wrong, but for the knowledge of a few handy hints and tips. Retouching varnish, in which I demonstrate the purpose of applying retouching varnish and how to go about it. Again, easy when you know how. In addition, two problem solvers, in response to a couple of queries posted online for me to resolve. How to deal with sticky paint, a not uncommon problem that is easily resolved when you know how. Understanding the purpose of the various oil mediums and thinners. As with all of my videos, these are filmed in real time, so that you can watch every detail accompanied by my running commentary.